The implementation of the $360 million projects under the Uganda Support to Municipal Infrastructure Development Program, USMID, started in 2013 with the need to close the gap between required urban service delivery and rapid urban growth by developing infrastructure in 14 municipalities in Uganda. While assessing the performance of the project today, members of the Local Government Public Accounts Committee have exposed a lot of shoddy works in the project, pointing at poor quality solar street lights which were installed in various municipalities.
The question of the street lights, I want to find out whether there was a study between the environmental effect, the design, and the specifications. Because all the street lights in the cities we visited had an effect on the environment that made them not function.
The basis that we used to choose the voltage for the solar lights, was it a gamble? Did we study? Did we apply it from another country? Which country? Can we rule out connivance with solar suppliers so that we see that your hands are clean?
Constructed a total of 78.4 kilometers of road in 110 urban roads, totaling to 78.4. How much did you spend in total to construct this 78.4 kilometers?
After traversing the country while monitoring the implementation of the project, the chairperson of the Local Government Public Accounts Committee, Martin Ojara Mapenduzi, noted that 60% of solar street lights installed in 14 municipalities have broken down in a short time.
Are you aware that in most of these municipalities, I'll give you the example of Gulu, Soroti, Mbale, and elsewhere, almost 60% of these solar street lights are not functional. They are not working. How then do we think that investment is realistic if even before a short period after installing them, they're not working?
Implementing this from local governments, using their savings, went ahead and procured their own street light, solar street lighting. That's why when the members go to Barara, you'll find that they procured the contractor with their own and installed the lighting without necessarily clearing the specifications with the center. So Barara did the same, Ntungamo, Lukazi, and Gulu.
The committee also grilled officials from the Ministry of Lands who implemented this project for inflating the unit cost of roads constructed under this project compared to the Uganda National Roads Authority roads. A total of 110 urban roads totaling 78.4 kilometers have been constructed in 13 municipalities.
In Imbarara, they told us that the average unit cost of a kilometer of road under UNRA was much lower than the average cost of a kilometer of road under the USMID.
Why a road, a 1 kilometer road in one city or municipality costs about 2.5 billion and in another city or municipality about 3 kilometers costs about 20 billion? We need to understand that.
We have got the pavement, we have got the walkways, we've got parking, we have got cycle lanes, we have got covered drains, we have got the ducts the PS has talked about, and we have got the solar lighting elements. There could be 2 lanes, there could be 4 lanes, depending on which road we are talking about.
The USMID implementers defended the inflation and variation in the unit cost of the urban roads, saying they are implementing a modern concept of urban roads which require covered line drains, pedestrian walkways, solar street lights, street trash cans, and signalized traffic lights.
We who are of the urban environment, who understand the urban environment more than anybody else, if you look at our designs, for example, we have things like ducts. You will have seen that in many towns and municipalities, you have got times the road has just been done, and then you have water people cutting or electricity people cutting across to lay service lines. So we have come up with a solution to have ducts incorporated in the designs, so that when some of these service providers come, they have already ducts where they can just lay their service lines.
The committee gave them 1 week to adduce documentary evidence against queries raised against the US MID implementation. Story by Fred Kajibi for the News at Parliament.